Coming up on Pierce County News. Go on a DUI ride-along in Puyallup. Local cities see new development and what you need to know for the 4th. Hi, and welcome to Pierce County News. I'm Heather Radall. In just one night, Pierce County deputies take 20 impaired drivers off the road because of drugs or alcohol. The Tacoma Pierce County DUI and Traffic Safety Task Force under Pierce County Community Connections is launching a DUI crackdown. Reporter Megan Hutton takes us on a ride along.
Speed limit on here is 35.
A special Saturday night patrol in Pierce County had deputies looking for drivers impaired by drugs and alcohol. 13-year veteran Deputy Bruce Johnston knows what he's looking for.
Driving faster or slower than the speed limit, jerky motions, driving at night without a headlights on. That's a good indicator.
His patrol starts off on Canyon Road near Puyallup.
176 in Canyon, Washington, Victor, Zebra, Boy.
At first, it's a series of routine traffic stops, but Johnston says it doesn't have to be late before the DUIs come out.
We're getting more in the afternoons. In fact, the last two I had were around between 2 to 5 o'clock.
Around 10 p.m., there's a call for backup on a drug DUI. A man from Eatonville is caught on Meridian. He's high on meth.
He took off at a high rate of speed and all the way down Meridian at 224th, he hit some stop sticks and he kept on coming down to here. He finally pulled in the parking lot here, hitting one of our police cars and went through the car wash where he was apprehended.
He hit a patrol car, had to be tased twice, and was driving on his third suspended license. Paramedics are called.
When was the last time you used?
An hour ago.
The man is first checked out at a hospital before being taken to jail. Around 1:30 in the morning, a car with three teens is coming home from a party when they hit a tree.
Forced to just follow with your eyes.
The 17-year-old driver agrees to a voluntary field sobriety test. She blows well over the legal limit.
She very well could have gone to the left into the oncoming lane. As you can see, there's a lot of traffic along the street, and she could have hit somebody very easily. She had two other people in the car, so she's endangering their lives also.
Right now you're under arrest for DUI.
In the last 2 years since Target Zero patrols began, Pierce and King counties have seen 40% fewer deaths and serious injuries from alcohol and drug driving. Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.
Tahale, the former Cascadia planned community on the Bonnie Lake Plateau, is under new ownership and construction is underway. Reporter Greg McClellan tells us what's coming this summer.
The sounds of construction are coming back to a development tucked away in Bonnie Lake. Tahale is designed to be a community where people can live, work, and play. This summer, the massive site will no longer look vacant as construction picks up for the grand opening.
The Welcome Center behind me will be complete. That has a cafe component in it that'll be open to the public. Everyone's welcome to come by, have a cup of coffee and a sandwich. And then the four residential neighborhoods we'll be selling. Also have about 10 miles of trails that'll be open this summer, and then six community and neighborhood parks.
Newland Communities bought the project out of foreclosure in March 2011. They just announced four builders, Lennar, Richmond American, Quadrant, and Benjamin Ryan. Model homes will be built starting in July. Homes in the first four neighborhoods will cost around $200,000 to $300,000 and range in 1,300 to 3,300 square feet.
Right now, we think we're just at the beginning of the economy improving. Obviously, we're making a significant investment with that belief. First will come the homes and home buyers, and then that'll start to create some momentum, and then we'll be able to start getting businesses.
Jones says in the next 10 years, the goal is to have office space, commercial, and light industrial businesses on the site. Newland will also be working on road improvements in the Bonnie Lake area.
The phase one mitigation is significant improvements on 198th corridor, which I think a lot of people are well aware of. There's a piece called the missing link that actually runs between the middle school and the high school in Bonnie Lake. We're already working on that piece right now. We're about 50% through the engineering, and the county's taking the lead on buying right away for that corridor.
At full build-out, the site will have 5,900 homes, as many as 7 schools, and more than 1,000 acres of parks and trails. Greg McClellan, Pierce County News.
The city of University Place is celebrating a huge milestone at Town Center. The city just broke ground on the Town Center's first private sector development.
It was a vision that was planned by the community back in 1995 when we incorporated. It's taken a long time, a lot of hardship, a lot of wondering if we were doing the right thing. And I think it's finally starting to show that sometimes good things take a long time to come to full fruition.
Community members and public officials gathered to kick off the new 5-story, 90,000 square foot development that will include 100 residential units and 12,000 square feet of ground level retail space.
If you're a real estate developer, this is a really exciting day, getting to the point where you're actually building something.
City Manager Steve Sugg says the private development will bring in about $12 million to the local economy.
We hope that this project is the first of many to transform our Town Center into a truly exciting social hub, a true sense of University Place, a true place in University Place.
The development will be located to the left of the Civic Building, which houses a police station and library. Construction is expected to be complete in 2013. Plans to design a new city center for Fife are officially underway. Business owners, residents, and city officials came together at a community open house to brainstorm ideas and help plan the future city center.
So the idea of a city center vision is really about looking at the transportation network and seeing how we could correct that up in ways that actually help redevelopment, economic revitalization, and kind of a bring together the goals of city council to make a more connected, pedestrian-friendly community.
The city is in the process of updating its 20-year transportation plan that opens the door for a new city center. Ideas for the space include a mixed-use area with housing, retail, mass transit connections, and better pedestrian access. The vision will be finalized over the next few months. Pierce County officials got a firsthand look at what to expect when the U.S. Open comes to Pierce County in 3 years. The U.S. Open at the Olympic Club near San Francisco just wrapped up, and the next time it returns to the West Coast, it will be at Chambers Bay. Joining me today is Matt Allen. He is the general manager at Chambers Bay and just returned from the U.S. Open in California. Matt, what is the biggest thing that you took away from the Open at the Olympic Club?
Well, I think because we were at a West Coast site, there was tons and tons of enthusiasm and excitement about Chambers Bay. Lots of questions, lots of people planning their trip to visit the Puget Sound. And in addition, it was just reinforced for us how the USGA are really pros at what they do. You know, they build a city for 60,000 people for that week, and they really know what they're doing.
Mm-hmm. Now, what are the biggest similarities and differences that you saw from that course in Chambers Bay?
Probably the starkest difference is the golf course itself. Certainly, you know, Chambers Bay is going to be the first Lynx golf course to host a U.S. Open. And the Olympic Club is a very traditional, classic golf course. Narrow fairways, tall rough, real precise play. So that's the biggest difference. There were some similarities for sure in the terrain at the Olympic Club. Lots of elevation change, I think some 200 feet over the golf course. So the USGA, like they'll have to do at Chambers Bay, did a lot to, you know, from a safety standpoint, to keep the spectators, you know, where they needed to be.
Mm-hmm. And speaking of that, I understand the USGA is already starting to get involved in the planning here.
Yeah, the USGA has been very involved since before Chambers Bay was built. Pre-construction, they were visiting, and they've had annual visits from their executive director, their director of U.S. Open Operations annually. Since 2007 or 8, my first visit with them was in March of 08, and they're going to be relocating 2 championship managers to the site, or to Pierce County anyway, this fall. So normally they relocate those staff a couple years before, but because we're a new market and a first time in the Northwest, they're sending staff out a little earlier than normal.
And what kinds of preparations can we expect to be seeing over the next year for the Open in 2015?
Yeah, when those staff get on site, they're going to be very focused on community outreach. number one, volunteer recruitment as a part of that outreach, and certainly corporate hospitality sales as well. We'll be working with them to put packages together and start getting the business community excited about participation.
All right, well, we are excited too. Yeah. Thanks, Matt.
Thank you.
If you drive on Wallachet in the Gig Harbor area, you'll want to know about a major traffic delay coming up. Traffic will go down to one lane on Wallachet near the Grange on Artindale while construction crews cut out part of the roadway and shift two lanes from the east side of the road to the west side.
During that time, which is estimated to occur around July 9th, that time frame, there's going to be some major delays as we transition the traffic primarily on the section between Artindale and East Bay.
Drivers can also expect minimal delays on Wallachet all summer between East Bay Drive and Fillmore Drive while crews work to widen the area to four lanes. Phase one of the Wallachet project between 40th and East Bay is expected to be complete this year, and phase two between East Bay and Fillmore next year. Once both projects are done, the roads will be 3 to 4 lanes wide with turning lanes. There will also be signal improvements and more than a mile of curbs, gutters, and sidewalks.
Well, I think they'll see a nice road, a sidewalk, curb and gutter, hydro seeding, grass. The storm system will pick up all, there's a lot of underground water, so it'll pick up that water. They'll have a nice place to walk their dogs where they'll be safe from traffic.
For updates and message boards, visit the project website at piercecountywa.org/Wallachet. If you plan to drive over the Tacoma Narrows Bridge, get ready to pony up some extra cash. The State Transportation Commission approved higher tolls to pay for increasing debt payments on the 5-year-old bridge. The toll hikes go into effect on Sunday, July 1st. If you're paying cash, it will go up $1 from $4 to $5. If you pay by mail, it will be $6. And good-to-go tolls will increase from $2.75 to $4. Coming up next, get the scoop on where it's legal to set off fireworks this 4th of July and what you should know about illegal fireworks. We're back in just 60 seconds.
I vow to make excuses when you humiliate me in public. To forsake my friends and family when you isolate me, and to value myself less when you belittle me. I vow to blame myself when you hit me, and to fear for my safety and the safety of our children till death do us part.
Don't ignore domestic abuse. Speak now. The Family Justice Center is a place of safety.
If setting off fireworks is part of your 4th of July tradition, there are some things to know before the holiday arrives. We all love big fireworks shows, but if you want to set some off at home, where you live determines if they're legal. Fireworks are banned in Faircrest, Ruston, Steilacoom, and Tacoma. They're also banned in all city, county, and state parks. Some cities like Milton, Puyallup, and Sumner allow most consumer fireworks, but only on the 4th of July during specified hours. Other cities allow them in the days leading up to the 4th. Another thing to keep in mind, anything that can be classified as an improvised explosive device, or IED, is illegal to possess anywhere in the state of Washington.
There's a zero tolerance for the IEDs. These devices will get you a citation. They will be seized. You will most likely be arrested. They have to be handled differently because of how they're classified. The bomb squad will have to be called out to mitigate the incident, and you, being the responsible party, will be responsible for all those costs for mitigating the incident, which could and most probably would run into the thousands of dollars.
Fireworks considered to be IEDs include cherry bombs, M80s, and pipe bombs. For a complete list of what fireworks are legal and where you can set them off, you can go to piercecountywa.org/FPB. If you plan on taking the Pierce County Ferry over the 4th of July holiday, you'll want to be aware of how low tides will affect your commute. From July 1st through July 8th, load restrictions will affect the Pierce County Ferry to and from Anderson and Ketron Islands during low tides. Large vehicles such as RVs, commercial trucks, or vehicles towing a trailer might not be able to board during certain times. The crew and ticket agents will evaluate large vehicles on a case-by-case basis. For a list of low tide restriction times, go online to piercecountywa.org/ferry. Up next, Parks and Rec has their own version of the Olympics, but your kids better be ready to get dirty. But first, here's some dates for your calendar. If you want to learn how to keep your heart healthy and know the heart attack symptoms for women, there are two free workshops coming up. The Dial 911 Don't Miss a Beat workshops will focus on women's heart health. They're sponsored by the Pierce County Aging and Disability Resource Center, and no reservations are required. Catch one of the workshops on July 9th at the Pierce County Annex or July 12th at the County City Building. For more information, call 253-798-4600. The third annual Gig Harbor Wine and Food Festival is just around the corner. Sample delicious food from some of the best chefs and restaurants in the Pacific Northwest, and taste fabulous wines and spirits from more than 24 wineries and breweries. The festival happens July 14th at the Harbor History Museum. For more information, go to harborwineandfoodfest.com. This week, Kyle Wintermute is getting us ready for the Gross Out Olympics. Hi, Kyle.
Hi, Heather. Hey, this outfit may seem pretty strange and very unfamiliar, but if you're going to be an official at one of this summer's most prestigious events, then things could get pretty messy. Plan early to get on the list for this summer's Gross Out Olympics. This ultra-messy event includes the most extreme of disgusting challenges that are not for the faint of heart. How about the bologna toss or the human cheese puff? No matter how silly or slimy, your child will rave about the fun they had at either one or all four challenges. Don't wait. Mark your calendar and get signed up today. Can't get enough of the views at Chambers Bay? Then get your running shoes on and sign up for one of the most scenic 5K runs you'll attend this summer. The run is July 21st with check-in at 7 a.m. and the start at 8 a.m. This event is for all ages and abilities, and we even offer a 1 mile dash that will take you along the Grand View Trail. Early registration ends on July 6th if you want to get the discounted price. So go online for more information and details. Getting messy comes naturally to kids, but not so much for us adults. So I'm going to towel off and I'll see you at the Gross Out Olympics. I'm Kyle Wintermute for Pierce County News. Back to you, Heather.
Thanks, Kyle. You can see Pierce County from here on PCTV. We have the original programming you can't find anywhere else. Next week, we're bringing you a special show from out at Northwest Trek. See the baby animals, and we'll take you on the new zip line. Catch it starting Thursday, July 5th. I'm Heather Radall. Thanks for watching Pierce County News.